to get up and run. Hold on a second. All right, gonna get way off topic today. How did I go from a non-runner to somebody that finished the 5K in under 6 weeks? Coming up today.
Hey there, Mike Steitner again for day 6 of the 30-day vlog challenge. So, are you looking to run a 5K? Well, so was I a few months ago, and having no previous running experience whatsoever, I started Googling around, and I just want to share with you some of the results because I was successful in completing my first 5K in just under 28 minutes, which is not a record, it's not epic, but at least I finished it. And I just want to share with you a couple of tips that really worked for me. The one thing was to really just to set the date. I recommend now, in retrospect, setting yourself up for about a 2 to 3 month training period, preparation time. I gave myself about 4.5 weeks, which really wasn't enough. I've completed the race, but I was really sore. You really want to try to give yourself like a day running and then a day off, like an every other day kind of a scenario, maybe running 3 days a week. So that's one thing. I would set a date because then you have a goal to work for. And then secondly, you want to really arm yourself with the right tools. Now running, you know, you're thinking, what does that require? You know, it just requires, you know, some lightweight shirts, some nice light shorts, really good running shoes. I suggest good running shoes, actually. I got a new pair of shoes about 2 or 3 weeks into my training, and I should have done it when I first started. So anyway, arm yourself with a good pair of shoes. And then there are a couple of great apps out there. The Nike Plus is a good one. I use one called 5K Runner. And what that enables you to do is you log into this app, and it starts you out really slow, like running for, walking for a minute, running for a minute, walking for a minute, and you kind of build up through the weeks, and you get to a point where you're running 15 minutes straight. So it's quite literally couched to 5K in the way that it's set up. Plus, you can listen to your music while you're running too. The apps are designed pretty well. Actually, I like the Nike 5K one, or the Nike Plus, I believe it is. You can interface with Facebook, and I've been doing that lately. It kind of gives some accountability to what you're doing. Your friends can see that you're running, and so kind of, like I said, it gives you some accountability. The third thing is to surround yourself with like-minded people. Now, that may not be the easiest thing to do if you don't have running friends, but you may want to check out your local running store where you got your shoes, perhaps. There's lots of different clubs in a lot of the larger metropolitan areas of the country. Check out meetup.com is another place to meet like-minded folks for a variety of different hobbies and that sort of thing. Another one is, you know, try to surround yourself with like-minded folks on Facebook or on YouTube. At least follow some runners on YouTube and subscribe to their channels, and you'll get inspiration, diet tips, and that sort of thing. One thing, I was talking about tools. This is a little armband that I got. It's pretty simple for putting your iPhone in or your Android or whatever, and it just goes right up on your sleeve or right up on your arm like this. And, you know, you put your headset on or headphones. Headset. Can you imagine running with a big pair of headphones? I also got one of these for the right arm for my keys and ID. And basically, as a bonus tip, I want to tell you about a site. Actually, I don't know the exact name of the site, but if you Google Couch to 5K, you're going to find a lot of different opportunities there to... there's a couple autoresponder sites that'll send you, you know, tidbits every other day, and I highly recommend that as well. Diet tips. I was getting in the morning before I would run, I'd have a banana and then peanut butter on a whole wheat bagel, half of a whole wheat bagel, so get the slow carb action happening. So anyway, those are my tips. Once again, consult your doctor before you take on any kind of new exercise regimen or program. And that's it. Good luck. We'll see you out on the streets.